Hello and welcome to the EventCam tutorial number 2. After taking the first recording in tutorial number 1, we now take a closer look into the configuration menu. We start in the first window we jumped over in the last video. In the image settings, we can select two different recording modes, the video and the picture mode. In the video mode, the highest spatial resolution to choose is 1920 by 1080 pixels with a maximum temporal resolution of 30 frames per second. With the lowest spatial resolution of 800 by 600 pixels, it is possible to reach a higher temporal resolution of 65 frames per second. In the picture mode, the highest spatial resolution to choose is 2592 by 1944 pixels with a maximum temporal resolution of 15 frames per second and a minimum of 1 frame per hour. The low spatial resolution is 800 by 600 pixels. In the next step, we can choose the duration of a video, or for the picture mode, the number of pictures taken for one event. In the video mode, the duration we can choose depends on the selected resolution. With the highest video resolution, we can choose a maximum of 25 seconds before the trigger and 15 seconds after the trigger. With the lowest resolution, we can choose a maximum of 240 seconds before the trigger and 100 seconds after the trigger. In the picture mode, we do not choose a time frame, but the number of pictures taken. Hereby, otherwise than in the video mode, the number of pictures does not depend on the temporal, but only on the spatial resolution. With the higher spatial resolution, the EventCam can store a maximum of 25 pictures before an event and a maximum of 25 pictures after an event. With the low spatial resolution, the EventCam can store a maximum of 120 pictures before an event and a maximum of 120 pictures after an event. In the next step, it is possible to configure the exposure control. For most settings, the default configuration works fine. For special requirements, you can customize the configuration to your needs. Below the configurations, we can see a live preview from the EventCam recording. When we change the configuration, we have to click on Update Preview to see the effects of the adjustments. With the option White Balance, we can adjust the color temperature of our recordings. The option Automatic Exposure Control gives us the possibility to turn the automatic adjustment on or off. Especially in a setting with changing light conditions, it is recommended to turn this option on. When it is turned on, you further have the possibility to adjust the image brightness, the object speed, and the brightness accommodation speed. Brightness accommodation speed may be adapted, for example, if reflections occur. When automatic exposure control is turned off, you have the possibility to adjust the gain control and the exposure time. These are settings for camera experts. In the next window, we can configure the image cropping. By default, this option is deactivated. If we turn it on, we get the possibility to crop the field of view of the recording. The X direction is the horizontal axis, and the Y direction is the vertical axis. To see the effect of our calibration, again we have to click on Update Preview. On the next page, we can decide whether we want to store the recordings on the internal storage or upload them via FTP to a server. After clicking forward, we see the configuration menu for the trigger. Here we can change the pin active state, and we can choose between different next image after trigger modes. Latter is just relevant in the picture mode. In the next step, we can set some options for the mute function. If we turn the Lock triggers discarded due to mute option off, Triggers won't appear in the log file when they happen in a moment the event cam is muted. The cam indicates that it is muted with a blue recording LED. Further, we here can change the status of the mute pin and the mute button. And we can configure the automatic unmute function. In the last step, we can change the IP address and the subnet mask of the event cam. Consider here, if you change something here, you again have to change the network status of your PC. By clicking on Finish, we end the configuration procedure. And so we also come to an end of this tutorial. I hope I could deliver some useful information. Have fun with our new product. Bye bye.